So good afternoon and welcome to the Cradle to Cradle event. Use of musical instruments made with natural materials and recycled products. A way to make inclusive education a reality through music and natural and spontaneous rhythms connected to feelings, languages and culture. I present Carmen Marino, Director of the Environmental Training Center of the Nature Workshop, teacher of Villa Viciosa Dodón, Ariadna Ruiz de Azúa, Environmental Educator, Teacher and Sociocultural Animation Technician. And you already know me, I am Agustín Bastida, I moderate the group Sustainability Education Network Service Training. Our planet is undergoing a complicated time of overexploitation of natural resources, and raw materials are beginning to run out. The productive model of consumer goods has made important progress in the reuse of materials and the elimination of potential dangerous products, but continues to process and create materials with the same approach as 50 years ago, when industries were more connected to their places of origin. The current era of globalized production needs answers and firm commitments in the design of the goods we consume. And Michael Rungard and William McDonough gave the key to this early in this century. From cradle to cradle, or from origin to origin, is a concept that involves many principles of sustainability, not only the economic. It pursues the search of a redesigning of the creation of products, taking into account factors related to the obtaining of the materials in a way which is respectful to the environment and the societies that are in its vicinity, the systems of production and elements that are key to the permanence of the present ecosystems and well-being of the societies of the planet. The concept C2C, or cradle to cradle, promotes the making of products following a parallel with the processes of nature, where the term waste does not exist. Since the elements considered as waste are taken advantage of by other living beings. According to the authors, Brungard and McDonough, the products must be made from pure components and easy to disable in order to create objects easy to recycle or otherwise create fully bio-recyclable objects that do not need to be recycled at all. The fundamental thing is to design objects that do not mix biological elements with technological elements in order to be recovered in their totality. Cradle to cradle certificates are currently issued when a number of factors are involved. Cradle to cradle products and services must ensure the use of environmentally safe and healthy materials. A design focused on reuse, recycling or composting, the use of renewable energy and energy efficiency, efficient and water-friendly use. Systematically, the general principles that in one way or another are part or contribute to global sustainability, we pronounce them as general principles of for sustainability because they contain fundamental ideas for guidance and they are universal, since they extend to all activities, to the whole world, and at all times. The achievements of our tendency towards sustainability must be a desire of human society in its relationship with nature, and in order to reach this, action must take place in a balanced and harmonious way from different spheres, sociocultural, environmental, and economic. The use of natural or recycled material makes it accessible to all people in any part of the world, and music favors group feelings essential for the inclusion of anyone in the different musical projects. In relation to the part of today's workshop, related to the elaboration and use of musical instruments with natural and waste materials, Arianna, or Piccola, as we familiarly call her, gives us a good example of how to use upcycling or natural materials, the ability to transform a discarded material into an object with greater value. And now I would like to introduce you to Piccola. Hello, Piccola. How are you?
Hello. Hi.
This is Piccola. She's going to show us how we can use natural materials or recycled products we consider waste and use them in our classrooms, just for the kids to integrate in and make the feeling to be formed or be part of a collective. So Piccola is a friend and colleague, and she's a fantastic dynamizer of groups as well. And I would like her introduce herself.
Hello, I'm Arianna, or Piccola. I've been playing percussion since about 20, 25 years ago. I usually work a lot with people that have problems. Like, I've been 15 years in jail. I work with little kids that have problems in their house or school, and we make music to try them to get a better feeling in their life. And now also I'm working here in this school farm, where I work with kids, and also I show them how to use music, not instruments, elements. We play here music in our work every day, in the morning and in the afternoon, because we think that the music is a good, what do you say, it's very good too. You get together or close people. I will tell you that if you don't have nothing to play with, you don't even need it. Most schools, for example here in Spain, they all have a table, not like this, smaller, but you can start only doing like, this is hard if you have little kids, but they can just go. Tables in your school, so you can start only doing things with your hands and with a table. Then I'm going to show you some elements, because in about 20 years ago I make instruments. Right now I don't really make them. I investigate for the quality of the sonido, Austin.
Sound.
For example,
As you realize, Piccola speaks English very well, so but she's a bit shy speaking English. Her English is fantastic.
For example, I bring some easy things, no? Like... a simple bar, okay, you can do a lot of things. You can make your child to close their eyes and to feel only. This reminds something. For example, today we did it here at the school farm, and I saw them this, some bottle, and this other bottle, and I made the kids to close their eyes, and I sounded like this. Start to tell me, oh, it sounds like water, it sounds like a storm, it sounds like the sea. So it's very
suggestive.
Yeah. There is a man, it's called Murray Schafer. There is a composer, and he makes a lot of things hearing only the environment. So then, for example, I wrote this. It's simple things, okay? It's when you have to cook something, okay?
It's the they are lids of boiling pan.
Okay, you can put it like this. Before, I usually played, like here in Spain, in a place called Valladolid. It's played this with the dedales, Agustín.
They are fingernails?
Okay. And with a fork. But I don't do it like this. I think it's easier because we work with little kids. So this is very difficult. So you only have to do like this. You can say, okay, you can do like this. Yeah, this is easy, no? I usually say to my kids that they have to throw up the things out in the air and let them stuck in the floor. Okay, because you can hear if the material is a good material or if it's not. For example, this is from a can. Okay, so when you throw it up away, you can hear. This is not so good, okay? Okay, so if I like it how it sounds, I start to investigate. I finally did this little instrument. Okay. I put many of these together, okay? And one of them. I like to play with my kids, so here we usually play a lot of this, so the sound is very heavy. Okay.
Sorry, Nicola. Yeah, yeah. Have you realized these are the bottom of cans or tins? Yeah? So Piccola Yes, made a hole in the center and joined together with a piece of wire. And she made this fantastic instrument. Very easy and cheap. And we are giving another use to all things.
Okay, I talked before about Murray Schafer, but there is one other man, I like them very much. It's called Jack Foley. Okay, he's one of the first guys that started working to put sounds in their films. So I learned a lot about him, because many times I have to do a lot of experiments. For example, I have different types of cans.
Sorry, Piccola. Yeah. Is Jack Foley reading like this?
Yeah.
And Murray Schafer?
It's Schafer.
Schafer. Okay, with a C. Okay. Because I'm going to write the names on the chat. Thank you, Piccola. Sorry. You realize that the components inside the tin are just the bottle of or soft drinks. Well, they are beers.
Okay, then you can just put it like this. These are the cans from the bar of work. Okay, so it's very easy. You only have to ask the people to take these things to your classroom. Okay.
Smooth, it's a smooth surface. It's a piece of stone, it's a marble.
Okay. We are This is things that we use every day here in our school farm. Okay, I got this from the school farm. I don't know in your countries, but here in Spain, it's very typical to play this. Okay, it's called mortero. In my little village, my old parents, they all play like this in the table, and they all play things like this. Okay, if you play it traditionally, you just go like this. Okay, here. Here. But if you don't want to play or this is too difficult for little kids, you just can do it like this. Okay? It is bigger.
That's using a simple wooden mortar.
Here, as we told you that this is a school farm, so this is what we use when we put here the wheat. Well, here, so the harina, how do you say harina?
Flour.
The flour, it goes out, and the other thing.
Yeah. That's a sieve. Yeah.
Make your kids to play with the sounds. It has to be fun. No? You have to have a good time, no? And after a while, when they grow up, they will have a knitting. Okay, so finally, after this and this, we got this from, how do you call it, huerto?
Orchard. Kitchen
okay.
Orchard.
This is natural from the orchard, okay?
They are pumpkins, dried pumpkins, and the sounds are the seeds inside the pumpkin.
Yeah.
This is the there are many kind of pumpkins in every place, even here in Spain. So probably in your country is the same. So when they are dry, get dried, the seeds are inside, and you can shake it and listen to the seeds moving inside the pumpkin. This is a different sort of pumpkin, and the sound, of course, is different as well. And what the piccola use inside the sieve are beans, as you can see here. It's very simple.
Because you don't have to be afraid to make music with whatever you have in your school or your environment, okay? Because many times people say, no, I don't have money, no, I don't. You just let your imagination go and fly. Well, I finally brought also another type of pumpkin. Okay, so you can also work with the pumpkins, the multiculturalidad y diversidad.
Okay. It's a multiculturality.
Because there are many of different of them. There are little, big, green, yellow.
The variety of pumpkins is immense, as you can imagine. Here in Spain, as in your country, probably is the same one. And Nicola has another pumpkin, who is going to show you, which is huge.
So I would usually, when I get to my, when I start my work with the kids, Many times I started like this, no?
Look at that! Where is Piccola?
So I asked them to raise their hands. You have to raise your hand if you know what is this. You can hear so lovely words. They said, half of the moon, or where the little mouse lives, no?
Uh-huh.
This is a huge one, okay? This is, I have another easy one or little one, okay? And this, you just, they also love it to play, you just have to go like this. Okay, there are many things in the table, so now the sound is set.
You don't need to touch it. I'm going to be the kid, dancing and playing, no?
Yeah, that's okay. And I always tell them that before you come and dance, you have to come here to the pumpkin and say to dad, okay, are you ready? Because we are done, we are going to dance with the world. And do a little bit like this and say, ready, steady, and go. And they go dancing and the other kids go like,
she's very good.
Oh, thank you. Then I have here, I don't know. Maybe this one, okay.
She's going to show us.
It's a draw?
Yeah, a draw.
Okay. So I put it
from an old piece of furniture.
Yeah. Okay. I put here two little things because I usually take it like this.
Yeah, like a trolley.
Yeah, like a trolley. Okay. And then I'm only going to put some pieces of wood, but and these pieces of wood, they were in the street. I didn't cut them, I didn't do nothing. The only thing I did, okay, is like everything. I play them. I say, okay, I like it, okay? So it's the only thing you have to do is, it's nice, okay? Not all the wood is nice. So you can see different types of wood, okay? From the streets, everything. So you only have to take a little box, it doesn't matter whatever it is, okay? And different pieces of wood. After, if you want to make like a super marimba, okay, you can look at the internet, there are many tutorials, okay? But it's very easy, you only need a box and some wood. Okay. Okay.
If you need any help, just tell me. Okay. Yeah? So, you want me to put it down on the floor?
Yes. Yes. We are going to go to some big round things, no?
So, she needs a space because the next instrument is huge.
Oh, I forgot one. Maybe I'm going to take it here.
Don't worry.
One, because
is it in
here.
Okay. These are pipes. They are polyesterian pipes.
I think that this is a nice one because you can see them, okay? They have a different larger
size or length.
Yeah, okay.
They are different length.
I'm now building a lot of this one, like 20, so everybody can play it. I put it in the hole, okay? This
is just plastic milk bricks. Okay. Yeah.
Because the idea is that each girl or boy is outside, they can play one of these because they have different tunes, no? Oh, doesn't sound here. Oh, it's because of
because
the table.
It's,
well, yeah,
it's
yeah.
A wooden table.
Well, it sounds very nice. Because of the table. It's a different thing. Okay. Flywood sorry for another day.
Well,
okay.
You need to practice with the pipes, with the plastic pipes at home, and tell us your experience. Because here they don't sound very, very well because of this
table.
Is made of wood and the sound is obscure.
Oh. For example, this can you can use the music to do music, you can do the music to make the sounds of a story. The kids can write in the school and you can make, oh, okay, I do it in some other places, not here because if I don't have the time to do it, but in some other places. My kids, they write stories. And then we put on the sound effects, and they usually like it a lot.
Okay.
So, like, for example, very easy, but like if you put some water here, okay, I'm going to drink a little bit.
I thought the water was for you.
It was.
Oh, look at that. That's fantastic.
I do it with discount that somebody give it to me here in the school farm. Okay. Because the people now they know me and they I brought this one. Like to start with my kids with this, okay? This is from
it's a lamp.
A lamp, okay? I tell them to put here.
And a hat?
Yeah, and a hat. And then I.
And then it's a gong.
Yeah, it's a gong.
Boiling pan, they are boiling pans of different sizes.
Okay, and I have to tell you that you not all the boiling pans sounds well. Okay, so you have to search and search and search. And after, I don't know, you're lucky in some 2 months or maybe years, I don't know. It depends. It's not easy to find some pans like this, okay? But you can do some with another pans, it's a different sound, but yeah, it's also okay. So I'm starting here.
The philosophy is to be coherent with the message of sustainability. So please, don't try to buy recycled musical instruments. Just try to find a nice piece of X things and check the sounds, which gives you the clue if they are good to be used as instruments. Just to, if they sound nice, you can incorporate into your instruments.
Yeah, I have here two easy super easy things. Okay,
Can you show them? Just one of them, not the, the blue things.
Okay.
As you see, we use them just to keep food for the animals or just water. So there were many times in industrial states, so you can use them for as an instrument.
I had here two pieces of wood also. You can use it like a clave, no? And I also had here, I didn't sew it, but okay. Okay, you can play like this, okay? And you can also play it. I usually play it a lot with my group of kids, like doing something here, for example, no? Okay, I don't know why, because they are also from the same house, but they sound different, okay? These three of them, I took it from the trash, from a place from a farmacia.
Ah, from a chemist.
Yeah.
They found outside the chemist.
I sometimes I go to the industries,
industrial estate area,
and I ask them if they have like things like this. So I just wash the trash and I take them. Okay, it's a good fork. You have always minimum two sounds. Okay, in the center and in the side.
I'm
Thank you.
Well done, Piccola. Very good. Thank you very much, Piccola. You are wonderful.
Thank you.
Fantastic. So, I will say, says, bravo. So, that was all, folks. If you have any question to Piccola, this is the time, because we need to keep on working. At this time, we are here at the work center, and we have children in our school farm. So, if you have any question for Piccola, you can type on the chat window, or you can raise your hands and I open your mic. Stephen says, thank you for the good ideas.
Stephen. Welcome.
And I go, thank you both. It was real pleasure. Thanks for all ideas growing in my mind. That was Sergio from Ceuta. So, any question? You are not obliged to ask questions. Just
start to try whatever you want with just things in your classroom or even in the patio, in the ground floor.
Playground.
Playground, here we put many times these things in the playground, okay? No, it's a formal class, you put it outside and they just start playing, and many times you just looking and you go writing and taking their ideas to them to take it to the class.
Well, thank you very much for attending this event. Very soon I will organize another event. Thank you a lot. For you all.
Thank you.
Bye.